We know that violence against women must end. And ending violence against women starts with gender equality. When women are not equal to men, they are seen as less worthy of respect. Disrespectful attitudes and behaviours are the foundation of any and every act of violence against women. So what's sport got to do with it? Sport is more than a game. It shapes who we are. Whether you're a player, a coach, a referee, an administrator, or a fan, sport influences who we are and how we live. Team sports, like basketball, teach the value of teamwork and communication. Swimming and the early morning training it requires teaches the importance of self-discipline and the rewards of hard work. And with 87% of Australian adults participating in some form of sport or physical activity, it's fair to say that sport can be as important as family, education, or faith in shaping our values and behaviours in life. So when inequality and disrespect are part of sport, it has a ripple effect on the rest of the community. When sport promotes and champions stereotypical versions of masculinity and femininity, these stereotypes seep into attitudes and behaviours in families, homes and schools. They become the norm. When degrading language and harmful forms of masculinity are justified as locker room talk, it normalises disrespect of women off the field. When aggression, intimidation, threats and violence are accepted as a way for men to resolve disputes on the field, we normalise emotional and physical violence in pubs, streets, and homes. But sexist attitudes and disrespectful behaviours are only part of the problem. Despite almost equal participation rates for men and women in organised sport at community level, women remain underrepresented in sport and underpaid at a professional level. As for decision making, just 1 in 3 board members in sport are women. And only 9% of television news reporting covers women in sport, compared to more than 80% coverage for men. Without equal representation and respect for women in sport, equal behaviours and attitudes off the field won't be achieved. The good news is, we can change the story. When we come together to challenge stereotypes, provide greater opportunities and choices for women, challenge harmful forms of masculinity and sexist language, and promote equal representation of women, we make sporting environments more inclusive, welcoming, and respectful for everyone. And when women and men have equal power, value, and opportunities in sport and in society, violence against women is less likely. It'll be a team effort, but sport can help change the story. Because ending violence against women starts with gender equality.